Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Woo!
Life is not trying, it is merely surviving. You're standing outside the fire. There's this love that is burning deep in my...
Well, that was sure a cheesy intro. Very cheesy. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. This is Stu Sutcliffe. RealStuSutcliffe@gmail.com. And I'm back with another low-budget video. Hey, no skin off my rear end. Well, I have a lot of disorganization going on here. What is wrong with this shirt, man? Why does it look like I have man boobies? That's not right. It still looks like it. I don't have man boobies. Well, I do, but I mean, you know, they're small. Okay. That's a little better. I want to address something to Anthony Greeno and Randy Gravett. You guys, you live in Delphi, as far as I know. You both live in Delphi. Why can't you give us some more facts? Okay, well, this is directed at Greeno because he goes out and does the, in-your-face camera interviews. But, Anthony, why can't you go out there and find out what the public wants to know? We want to know how the girls were murdered, where they were murdered, and how long did it take? Nobody's addressing those. All the great videos and investigations that have been put out and... reenactions and all those you reenacted the crime and how they were led down and the side of the bridge and down the hill and this is in broad daylight too. Okay, the girls were taken in broad daylight. It's hard for me to fathom that what was done to them was just done out in the woods with a zillion people. I don't think it went down like that. I just don't. I want to know how it went down. Anthony, get out there and stick some microphones in people's faces and just demand, you know, go to the right people, go to the right sources. Man, you live there, man. And you probably know how it went down. I'm not saying for sure, but for whatever reason, you probably know these details, but you don't want to share them either because, yeah, you live there. And maybe out of respect for somebody. But come on. Do some digging and let us know. Let us know where the kill site was. And I'm not quoting any Robert Lindsay here. I'm just saying, I don't think it went down fast. I think they were taken to a place. We all talked about that structure that you discount. You know, they had crime scene tape up there, flowers and all that. You know, what's the reason for that? If that didn't play into it, you know, and the Mears property, I guess that's what I'm referring to. Not beating a dead horse. I've said it before. So, you know, come on, share with us what you know, man. I think you know more than you're letting on to. And don't give me that bunk that, oh, it'll hamper the police investigation. I don't buy that. So that's my request to you. Let's see what you can do. Give us some news on what you think happened and how long it took. Why didn't the searchers find the girls the first time around? It was to my understanding that they had looked in that area the first search. And then in the morning when the sun came out and they did the other search, that's when the girls was found. Did they have dogs on the first search? I don't know. Okay, so that's that. Okay, I want to talk to you all about the Freedom of Information Act. Ah, also known as FOIA. The FOIA Act. This is a sample sheet of Indiana sample FOIA request. Okay, Freedom of Information Act. We should be able to get a hold of these dudes and ask them some questions about this investigation too. So what you have on this, basically what you have to go to do this, you have to put your name, a street address, city, state, zip code, and the date, and you're gonna send it to the name of the custodian of records, whoever that would be, Carroll County, Indiana. I don't live in Indiana. Okay. Your title, your company name, if you have one, your street address, your city, state zip code. And the letter reads something like this. It says, "Dear whoever it is, custodian of records, under the Indiana Access to Public Records Act 5-14-3-1 ETSEQ, period, comma, I am requesting an opportunity to inspect or obtain copies of public records that," and then you describe the records or information that you're seeking with enough detail for the public service agency to respond. Be as specific as you can. Okay. So, be as specific as your knowledge of the available records will allow. But it is more important to describe the information that you are seeking. And it goes on to, the application goes on to say, the requested information is in the public interest and will contribute significantly to the public's understanding of, then you got to put what it is, the Abby and Libby murder case, or reasonable facsimile thereof. Here you can identify yourself as a representative of the news media, if applicable, and state that your request is related to news gathering purposes, Anthony. This information is not being sought for commercial purposes. So you're not supposed to make any money off of the information. The Indiana Access to Public Records Act requires a response time within 7 business days. If access to the records I am requesting will take longer than 7 days, please contact me with information about when I might expect copies or the ability to inspect the requested records. If you deny any or all of this request, please cite each specific exemption you feel justifies the refusal to release the information and notify me of the appeal process available to me under the law. Thank you for considering my request. Sincerely, Stu Sutcliff, or whoever it is. Okay. Request for Freedom of Information Act, FOIA. Now, you ready for the good part? After I've told you all that, guess what your chances in getting any of this, anything you request? Do you know, kiddies, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? A big fat zero. They won't give you zip for this because they'll tell you that it's an ongoing investigation and we can't jeopardize the case by giving you this. Anybody surprised? Some of you already knew that would be the outcome. Every FOIA request I've made, and during my life I've made about 3 of them, I never got zip back. One time I got back a paper that I had requested, and everything I wanted to know on the paper was blacked out with a permanent marker, which was about 3/4 of the page, just blacked out. And I called them, well, what the hell's up with this shit? Yeah, we can't jeopardize the case. It's an ongoing investigation. So you could probably request this paper 5 years from now or 50 years from now, and I'll tell you the same thing. Okay. So that's it for the FOIA. I'll just use it to line my birdcage with. Mr. Bridge Guy, this is for you. This is Uncle Stewie, Mr. Bridge Guy. You're a real son of a bitch asshole. What are you doing right now, dude? What are you doing today? Did you go to Starbucks? Did you go fishing? Got anybody that you've confided in? Who's your friend? Who's your accomplice? Do you hang out with him still? I bet he'd like to turn your ass in for the $230,000 reward. Can you imagine a reward like that? I don't even think the Lindbergh baby, when he disappeared, they had a reward. That one, maybe they did. It's $1 million. I haven't forgotten about you, Mr. Bridge Guy, if you're the one or whoever the perp is watching this video. What are you thinking? Like I said before, man, did you go fishing today? Did you catch any catfish? Yeah? No pun intended. You jerk. Who's that guy that always tells people off on that conservative radio talk show? What is that? Mark Levin? I like Mark Levin. I wish I could talk like him when he gets down there and goes, "You idiot! You jerk!" And then he hangs up on him. I listen to some of the conservative talk shows. But anyway, no, Mr. Bridge Guy, we haven't forgotten you. I'm trying to get more information out there of the horrible deeds you did. And make no mistake about it, ladies and gentlemen, what was done to Libby and Abby was horrible. It wasn't quick. You know, people out here saying, oh, it was over real fast. No, it wasn't. How do they know? If they don't even know, I don't know either. But it wasn't fast. No. And don't forget the two dates of the times of death. The 13th and the 14th of February, 2017. They both weren't even on the coroner report. Can we get the coroner report under FOIA? No. No. You won't get zip. So, Mr. Greeno, please, the public beseeches you. We just beg you to go out and find out the answer to these facts and report back. And don't be scared of what the townspeople are going to do, man. If they were going to be pissed at you, they probably already are. Don't be politically correct now, dude. Now's not the time to be politically correct. Give us a report on where it was done and what was done. We've heard everything from garroting to whatever else was the cause of death. Did you by any chance see them at the wake? Did you go to the viewing? You've never talked about that. If you went to Libby and Abby's viewing, well, what can you do about it? Mr. Bridge Guy won't turn himself in because he has no empathy. Well, the fear of turning himself in, but the guy evidently has no empathy. Doesn't care who he kills. He's still out there. Where is he? Is he in the country? Is he in Mexico? Is he on the Rio Grande? We don't know if he was a businessman or a hog farm worker or... Ooh, sound like a Honda Goldwing just went by. What the heck, man? Got bikers that live in my neighborhood. They'll protect me if I need them. Well, I don't know what else to say to Mr. Bridge Guy. I've said pretty much all I can. He knows his next move or lack of next move, and he's still scared. He's happy, he's laughing about it, but there's a part in him, a little pit in his stomach there that's scared. How did he get away with it, ladies and gentlemen? How did he do it? And the clues that Libby left behind on her phone blows my mind. I'd like to see this case solved one day. It might not get solved. It might not get solved for 20 years. Somebody's got to come forward. The police run out of, well, what can you do to investigate? You run out of things to investigate, and you're relying on the public. But remember, folks, most of these FOIA requests, if you ever try to get them, law enforcement will they'll wiggle their way out of it. You won't get it. You won't get zip. All right. That's my musings for today. And enough of my lament. Hope everybody has a good one, and kiss your children. Pick up your children, hug them, and kiss them today. You never know when it'll be your last time, okay? I'm going to hit the stop button now. Good day.